Hi, I'm Sarah, and welcome to Lohre Farm. This is Chaos Garden. We basically had a ton of extra seeds that were a year or two old, and just some extra from this year where we thought, what are we going to do with all these seeds? We don't want to store them anymore. So we just threw them in this field. My husband had made a video with the different implements that we have for the tractor and kind of tore up this random patch in our field. So we just threw all the seeds everywhere. So in here we have pumpkins, corn, dill, kale, lettuce, sunflowers, beans, everything you can imagine. And it has just, we haven't done any maintenance in here. We haven't weeded, we haven't watered. We were just like, you know what? We'll let it just be chaos, thus the name Chaos Garden. And it has exploded, and I'm really excited to see specifically how the squash do, because they are looking really good. I am starting to see little flower buds on them. And since we have no idea where we planted anything, we just came out here and threw them. It's gonna be really interesting to see what survived and how well it did. But look at this. We have corn, randomly. We have squash, possibly pumpkin, could be zucchini, could be yellow squash. We have it literally everywhere. If you look close enough, we got beans growing in here. We have kale and dill and a bunch of other herbs. I have some sunflowers in here. It is amazing how well it's doing. And I gotta tell you, I think next year we're gonna do this again. I think this is gonna be a staple with our leftover seeds. So we are in our cornfield. We planted 20 rows of corn this year. We did the first 5 rows with Korean natural farming methods. We used a solution where we soaked the seeds in the first 5 rows in it and then planted them. They seem to be doing phenomenal compared to the ones where we did not do the Korean natural farming too. They are greener, they're a lot taller, the plants look healthier. We're definitely gonna be doing this next year. Except for all of the plants, we're gonna do Korean natural farming, because on the plants that we have done it, they have really grown leaps and bounds above just the plain old organic farming. Everything in these 5 rows is gonna be ready in the next week or two. And Shane and I sampled one tonight. It was absolutely delicious. It was sweet and beautifully colored. We literally took it right out of the field and just ate it raw. And it was really good. You should cook it, but you don't even really need to. We're in the back garden where I have my zucchini, cucumbers, and pumpkins. We have an abundance of them. I like zucchini because they have a nice long growing season, and if you're a beginner gardener, it's a place to start because they do have the longer growing season and they're pretty easy to maintain and take care of. They're very easy to grow. You want to make sure that you pick them at varying stages. People that like flavorful ones will pick them when they're a little bit smaller. Sometimes with the flower still attached, those ones are going to be your most flavorful. And then I do find a lot of people like to buy them when they're bigger. We use the bigger ones for zucchini breads and zucchini cookies.
So this is my lemon cucumber plant. They do have a slightly long grower season than regular cucumber plants. They're just kind of like a fun novelty cucumber to have. They're a little bit lighter in flavor. They are called a lemon cucumber because they're shaped like a lemon and they turn yellowish when they're ripe. But otherwise they do still taste like cucumber. They are not part of the lemon family. They're literally just called lemon cucumbers because of the shape and the color of them. So we have a variety of different types of cucumbers back here. We have the lemon cucumber, the pickling cucumber. The pickling cucumbers are smaller for pickling. We did do a bunch of pickling this week because we had about 2 baskets full of pickling cucumbers. So we'll be having plenty of pickles in our future. So we also have regular cucumbers. I did pick a basket full of these this week also. So we'll be making a lot of cucumber salads, which was one of my Grandma Vera's favorite things. Sure, cucumbers are great back to school time because they're really good to just throw in your kids' lunchbox You can just eat it straight. For the lunchbox, because they're small and kids seem to enjoy them because they're a little bit more flavorful and fun.
So we already have one pumpkin growing, which is great. We're gonna have a ton soon because this whole field is all different varieties of pumpkins. It's kind of nice on a day like today to have a pumpkins because it kind of brings on that whole, today's like 100 degrees here in Minnesota. So this just kind of reminds me that fall's around the corner and cooler days are on the horizon. And with gardening, you love spring because it's planting and everything's exciting and you get to organize your garden and figure out where you're going to go with it for the summer. And then you got summer where it's harvest time, and then you got fall when things are kind of wrapping up for the year. But something I really look forward to in the fall is pumpkin season. You can do so much more with pumpkins than just Halloween, like pies and cakes, and they're really good as a whole body cleanse just to eat them. So I love fall, and I also love pumpkins because it reminds me of fall. We're in greenhouse number one, where I have my beets and beans. And we have picked a ton of beets this week. We've had them every night for dinner. They are perfect size, a little bit bigger than a golf ball size, smaller than a baseball size is where you get that like really sweet taste. Pretty exciting this week, and they're pretty picked through, so I'm gonna start replanting in here, because the one really thing that's exciting about this time of year is not only the harvest, but you also get to replant. One of the common biggest mistakes I've noticed with people in gardening is they plant in the spring and they think that's it, then the season's done as soon as you pick it. The good news is it doesn't have to be. You can also plant your fall crops in the summer and get them ready, like your lettuces. We're in greenhouse number two, where, as you can see, everything is growing fabulously. Shane's tomato plants are actually starting to work. I didn't think they were going to because we lost two of them. As you can see, them sad little tomato plants just hanging on by literally a thread, and this beautiful butterfly flying around. So the tomato plants are starting to flower here. So these are actually working. That's why it's kind of fun to try new things in gardens, is sometimes they work out and it's pretty awesome. So I went through this week and kind of pruned through the squash. I know you can't really tell because it's just exploded again because of the amazing climate that we have inside of the greenhouses. So I'm probably gonna have to go through here and prune again, but that's okay.
I'm in greenhouse number two today, and I'm gonna be doing a little bit of work cutting back some of the squash plants because it's gotten so out of control. I'm gonna start by cutting back the wilted leaves. I'm gonna cut them all the way to the stem in here. Some people do leave 3 to 4 inch long parts by the base so they don't tip over, but since there's really no problem with wind in here because they are kept inside, I don't see a need to do that. Also with that, sometimes I guess you can get bugs here. And my purpose for doing it in here is to get better airflow because they are so overgrown. I'm a little bit worried that the too much heat in here and not enough airflow that things are gonna start to rot. So I'm just gonna go through, and like I said, cut through some of these leaves. So things you'll need when pruning are, I like to have a pair of gloves because they have the little prickles on there to keep predators out. And then also pruning shears. You're gonna wanna clean your pruning shears with rubbing alcohol just to make sure that they're clean and not spreading disease throughout. And if you do have like mildew or something, then you're gonna wanna wash them in between. I'm not gonna do that in here because the leaves are already all touching each other because it's so overgrown, so it's kind of pointless at this point. But when they are properly spread out, I would advise when you're switching from plant to plant to use rubbing alcohol and clean your pruning shears. I'm also gonna keep everything in a bucket, 5-gallon bucket, just to make for easier cleanup. And also that's a good idea if you're pruning to not spread disease, separate and not just thrown next to an already healthy
plant. It really exploded this week with vegetables. The squash are growing amazingly. Each plant probably has 7 or 8 squash, which is awesome. We're gonna have a ton of these. We're gonna have to make a lot of veggie salads, which is great. Save us a ton of money at the grocery store.
The peppers are doing awesome. As you can see, there's a ton of them. Every plant is just exploding with them. I don't think there's a plant without any. The jalapenos over here are getting really big, and I think, I don't know, what is there, 7 or 8 on that one? We have a ton on all of them, even little baby ones on this little green pepper plant. This green pepper plant's got quite a few on there. That green pepper plant's doing amazing. I mean, they're literally sprouting everywhere. This one's really taken off height-wise. And these will grow well into September, as long as we can keep it nice and warm in here. And they will keep flowering and keep producing. They don't have a super long life cycle like squash, but they'll still produce for quite a while. So it's pretty awesome how phenomenal these are actually doing. Planter box garden, which is a raised bed planter box garden made out of pallets that my husband Shane made. Back here I have tomatoes, potatoes, green beans, carrots, garlic chives, beets, and I think that's everything. And it's also harvest time this time of year. It is the first week in August. And we've had just an explosion of produce this week. Tomatoes have gone bananas. We actually got to eat our first one with dinner, which was super exciting because I've been waiting all season for a fresh tomato. And we got a big beefsteak one, which usually those ones are later in the season to redden, but this one was red and we were able to eat it and it was awesome. Also our cherry tomatoes have exploded this week too. We've had quite a few of those. Those are kind of nice. You just pick them off the vine and pop them in your mouth. This is our carrot portion of the planter box garden. They haven't started shouldering yet. I did go through and thin them out this week, so I expect things to really start popping here shortly. So I'm picking through the carrots here. We're gonna thin them out a little bit because as you can see, they've gotten a little bit thick. More space in here. So then that'll hopefully encourage the other ones to start growing a little bit wider. Nothing goes to waste. We will throw all the trimmings to the chickens and they will eat it up. So now that we've gone through and thinned out the carrots, this will hopefully encourage them to grow deeper and longer. And we will go ahead and take these trimmings and throw them to the chickens. One really cool thing we did find while thinning them out was a parsley worm, or it's a caterpillar, and they eat toxins from the plants. So that's always a really good sign. Kids thought it was pretty fun. One thing we did back in the planter box garden was we put these posts in so we could maximize our space. So what we did in all of these is we put snap peas in between the sections of the garden, and those have obviously worked phenomenally. We went out and picked these yesterday morning and it looks like we need to go through and pick them again because that's how great they're doing. These are really good. They just snap, you can hear that. Really fresh, kind of sweet. They're really nice to just pick off the vine and eat as a good snack. This is the bean portion of the planter box garden. It has also done really well. It is all over. You can dig through here and find tons of beans to eat. I was going through here yesterday and picking and I found a snake skin. So there's probably a gardener snake living in here, which will control mice and stuff. We've been having a lot of beans this week. The good thing about them, as soon as you pick them, they flower again. They have a nice long season. Beans are one of the easier vegetables to grow, so if you're gonna start a garden, you're a little bit hesitant on where to maybe begin, green beans is a good place to start. They have a long growing season. They have one of the longest growing seasons out of all of the vegetables. And they're pretty easy to grow in every climate. So I guess that would be my advice, would be start with green beans. We're at the potatoes in the planter box garden and they're looking really good. They are tipped over, which is a sign that they are ready to be harvested. I did go through them a little bit and we will be picking these in the next day or two because they really are ready to go. We have two variety in here. We have Redskin and I think it was Yukon. Both of them are ready to go. They're really tasty. It just kind of with preference on how you want to eat it. Do you want like a baked potato? Then you're going to go with a Yukon. If you like them sliced, diced, and thrown with beans or something, then a red skin I think tastes a little bit better. I like potatoes because they're pretty easy to grow. They're universal. You can use them for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Yeah, they're an all-around good produce. This is my loofah, which they've always been a little bit of a struggle, but this year they're taking off and I'm really excited about it because I actually have flower buds. I have never gotten this far with loofah, so I am very hopeful and super excited to see if these actually gourd out. That would be awesome, and it looks like there is a really good chance of that happening. Like I said, this is the furthest I've gotten them. They're minus these little ants here. Little stinkers. They're flowering out really great. They have actually tendrilled through the corn crib that my husband built, and they're coming out all the way through the front, which is super beautiful at the very least. Well, they're not getting eaten too badly, so that's a good thing. They're looking. You know, the thing about elderberry plants is they're really good for you, but if you eat them raw, they'll make you violently sick. So you have to like actually cook everything down out of them, and then they're super beneficial. Makes you wonder who like thought, ooh, I'm gonna eat this, got violently ill, and then thought, oh, you know what? I'm gonna boil it down. That'll make it better. It's a good thing they did though. Thanks for watching our weekly garden tour. If you saw something you like, please hit the like button. And if you're not subscribed, please subscribe. I'll be putting out another one next week. This week was the first big harvest. Next week I think is gonna be even bigger. So I'm excited to have you back. Got our first harvest in of the year. We got the first harvest in for this year. I'm harvest. Creepy flowers. Look at these amazing flowers. They just grow naturally and abundantly all over our land.